Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. First of all, I want to thank all of you for the love and support you have given me. So today on this beautiful occasion of Ganpati Bappa, I will be showing you how to make a veg thali. So let's get started.
Okay, our first element is dal. So for that we will need 1 cup tuvar masoor dal, 1.5 tomato medium size chopped, 1/2 teaspoon hing, 1 teaspoon haldi. Put all the ingredients in the cooker, add 3 cups of water, mix well and give 3 whistles. So the next element is rice. We will need 2 cups of rice, 4 cups of water. We'll add the rice and the water to the cooker. Now we'll add salt. After adding the salt, we'll mix well. We'll close the lid and give 2 whistles. So now we'll need the ingredients for dal tadka. So for that we will need 1 teaspoon rye, 1 teaspoon zeera, 1 tablespoon adrak lasan paste, curry patta, red chilies and green chilies, 1/2 cup coriander, salt to taste. For the tadka, we'll add oil to the pan. After the oil is heated, we'll add rye. We'll wait for the rye to pop. We'll mix. Now we'll add zeera. After adding the zeera again, we'll mix. Now we'll add the curry patta, red chilies and green chilies. After that we'll mix for 2 minutes. Now we'll add the adrak lasan paste to it. Now we'll saute this. The tadka is ready. Now we'll put it in the dal. After adding the tadka to the dal, we'll wait for the boil. The dal is boiling, now we'll add the coriander. Now we'll add salt. Okay, so the dal and rice is ready. Now we are going to make the potato ka bhaji. So for that we will need 4 medium size potatoes. Half tablespoon rye, 1/2 teaspoon zeera, 1 medium size chopped onions, green chili, curry patta, haldi and kasturi methi. Now we'll add oil to the pan. We'll wait. Now we'll add the rye. We'll wait for the rye to pop. Now we'll add the zeera. Once the zeera is added, we'll mix. After that, we'll add the curry patta and green chilies. We'll mix. Now we'll add the onions. We'll saute it till the onions soften. Now we'll add haldi. We will saute it till we get a beautiful yellow color out of the haldi. Once we get the texture, we'll be adding potatoes. After adding the potatoes, we'll mix well. Now we'll add the kasturi methi and salt. We'll mix well. We'll add little water. We'll mix well. We'll put the flame on slow. We'll cover the lid and wait for the potatoes till they are cooked. So the next element is pulao. So for that we will need cooked half rice, 1 cup of peas and carrot, 5-6 long with 1 bay leaf, 1/2 teaspoon zeera and salt to taste. For the pulao, I'll be adding oil to the pan. Now I'll add the zeera. Now the long and bay leaves. I'll mix it. Now I'll be adding the carrot and the peas. I'll mix this. Now I'll cover the lid for 2 minutes till the carrot and the peas are softened. Okay, 2 minutes are done. Now I'm going to add the rice. I'll add some salt, I'll mix it. And the pulao is done. Now I'll be moving to the next element. Okay, so our next element is eggplant crisps. So for that we will need one big eggplant. We will be cutting it into slices. We will be soaking this in rock salt water for 1 hour. And now for the marination, we will be needing 1 teaspoon pepper, 1 teaspoon chaat masala, salt as per taste. And for frying, we will be needing breadcrumbs. So this is how the eggplant looks after it's marinated. And now we will be frying it. So this is how it looks once it's shallow fried. So now we are moving on to the next element, that is rice ghee. So for that we will be needing 1 cup powdered rice, roasted cashew badam, elaichi, 2 tablespoon ghee, 1 cup sugar, milk masala. Okay, so once the pan is hot, we'll put 1 teaspoon of ghee and then we'll put 1 liter milk. After adding the milk, we'll mix the ghee and the milk together. Once the milk is warm, we'll be adding the sugar. After adding the sugar, we'll mix the milk and the sugar. We'll wait for the sugar to dissolve. After that, we'll be adding the elaichi. After adding the elaichi, we'll mix all the ingredients together. Then we'll be adding the powdered rice. After adding the powdered rice, we'll mix all the ingredients together. And then we'll be adding the rest of the ghee to the kheer. So this is how the kheer looks once it's done. So our last element is puri. So for that we will be needing moist atta. So this is how you have to roll your puris. So now we are going to deep fry the puris. So for that we will be adding oil in the pan. Now we'll get to the plating. Okay, so we are done with Ganpati Bappa Thali. So on the thali we have potato ka bhaji, eggplant crisp, pulao, dal rice, puri, rice kheer garnished with masala milk and badam and cashew.
Thank you all for watching my video. Those who are new to my channel, kindly like, subscribe and share. Wishing you all a very happy Ganesh Chaturthi. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.